Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is the first of the first ever series that I'm launching here on my YouTube channel. I'm really excited to break down my monthly favorites with you guys on the first Thursday of every single month. And what better month to start with than January? So let's break down my January favorites. Okay, let's do this. Ooh, wow. I just made myself an iced honey latte at home. If you've been following me for a long time, I'll put my Instagram handle here. If you are not familiar with me at all, and you have no idea who I am. Hey, I'm Haley. I've talked a lot on Instagram about my love for iced honey lattes, and I typically go to, you know, like craft coffee shops because they always make really good ones. And I was like, you know what? I feel like I can do this at home. So I did today, and oh my gosh, I'm never gonna have to go to a coffee shop again. I'm gonna save so much money. It's gonna be great. So that's probably going to be in February's monthly favorites. But let's get into January. Let's start with beauty products. And just a heads up, this is not gonna be a whole video about products in general. This is a really fun video with lots of variety, so don't think that this is just product after product after product. But let's start with beauty products just because I have them right here next to me. So the first beauty discovery that I no longer can live without is this Emerald CBD Oil by Herbivore. This product I purchased in the very beginning of January, and it was really to help me fight some of the redness that I felt like my skin was experiencing. I felt like my nose was always really red and my chin, and this is a long-standing issue, and so I really wanted to find a product that would help combat that. This product definitely does that. It really helps to soothe and settle my skin, but it also provides a deep amount of moisture. So if you are someone who has really dry skin, and if you have been really afraid of oils, I cannot recommend oils enough. And what I love about Herbivore is that they are really, really focused on creating clean products. So that is something that I am definitely trying to find more of this year in my beauty regimen and in my beauty routine. The products that I'm bringing in and using on my skin, I really want to make sure that they are clean products. So this is one that I have found that is 100% clean. And just so you know, everything will be linked down below in the description box. All you need to do if you're new to YouTube is just tap on the title of the video and the description box will drop down. Okay, so the next beauty product that I can no longer live without is this new curling wand. I'm not sure how long it's been out, but it's new to me. My friend Megan, who does my natural beaded row hair extensions, she told me all about this curling iron and how amazing it was. And after she cut my hair to this new length, she did these like really effortless beachy waves, and I was like, I love this. For whatever reason, I had a really hard time doing it with my T3 wand, where I think the barrel was about an inch long. And what's interesting about this one is that the barrel is extra long. It's about 2 inches. And that really allows you to kind of put more hair in the clip and curl it in a really easy, effortless way. And I just find my curls to be really, really loose and fun. Kind of giving me a completely different look than I'm used to. And I am just really liking it. I love that there's a lot of different heat settings based on, you know, your personal preference. I personally always have it on 390. The one little critique that I do have is that I do kind of feel like the clip isn't quite strong enough, but I find that I feel like that only when my hair is super, super clean. Otherwise, when my hair has some grit to it, I do feel like it holds really, really well. So that's my only little critique, but I do think that this is a really, really great curling wand if you are looking for a new hair tool and are looking to create these really fun, effortless waves. All right, my last beauty favorite for the month of January is actually a brand. And I've gotten 3 products from this brand, and I'm just so, so impressed. I believe it was in my 2020 resolutions post where I'm really trying this year to be more aware. I want to learn more about what we can do to reduce our carbon footprint, how we can make more sustainable purchases. So I'm really just looking to make smarter purchase decisions. The more aware that we are and the more intentional we are, I think that we can all make a big difference. So this brand, Necessaire, is one that I became aware of the very beginning of the month. I had heard about it through influencers, to be honest, but I didn't work with them. I didn't purchase it because of any of them. To be honest, I didn't really hear them talking about anything in regard to how important sustainability is to this brand. And it was that fact that really got me to want to purchase their products. So I'm gonna read you actually something on their website that I was really, really impressed by. It says, "We are sustainable. We use 85% post-consumer waste boxes and 100% recyclable paper for our boxes and shippers. We only work with the FSC certified vendors. No virgin forest materials are ever used." They also go on to say, "What we believe, it has to be necessary. The ingredients we choose, the product we develop, the facts we share, the experts we interview, the footprint we leave behind." And then they go on to talk about how they practice clean beauty. Anyways, I have loved these products. Okay, so I got their body wash, as I shared. A lot of their products don't have any scents, so it's fragrance free, but this one is eucalyptus and it smells divine. Like, it literally fills up my entire bathroom and smells like that for a while after I get out, and I just love it. And then I got the fragrance free body exfoliator. So this is a really great product if you're trying to take off the last little remnants of your spray tan before you go get a new one, or if you've been traveling a lot or like walking around in a really large city and you just really need like a deep clean. You just feel like you just need a good solid wash, you know? So the last product I got from them was their body lotion, and I have found this to be such an ultra moisturizing body lotion. So I've been really impressed with Necessaire. I love that it's not only important to them to ensure that the products that we are using of theirs don't harm us through how it's formulated, but they are also just very intentionally ensuring that every part of the consumer experience, whether it's the product or what it's shipped in, et cetera, is not going to hurt the environment. So I really hope more brands do that in the coming years. Okay, so that does it for beauty favorites. I think we should segue into Amazon next, because doesn't everyone love Amazon? So I found quite a few things on Amazon this month, and I really had to narrow it down because I didn't want the list to be way too long. If you want me to maybe do a YouTube video all about my favorite Amazon finds of the last like year and a half or so, please let me know in the comments below. I would love to do that video. Okay, so the three Amazon purchases that I did end up choosing to share with you guys today kind of do the same thing that some of the beauty products are doing. They really help me to move one step forward in my journey to have a smaller carbon footprint. I think that we can all do a little bit of a better job reducing our single-use plastic use. So I am cutting out plastic baggies around the house, as well as doing my absolute darndest to not use any plastic bags at the grocery store. But to get rid of plastic bags, I am replacing them with these Stasher bags. And these are pure silicone. There is absolutely no plastic in these, completely BPA and BPS free. And it complies with FDA and European food grade standards, and they don't contain any byproducts or fillers of any kind. You can freeze these, microwave these, they're dishwasher safe, and I have loved having them as a replacement for plastic baggies around the house. The next item that has really saved me and helped me reducing my single-use plastic use this month is this little guy. I showed you this in my weekly vlog that I did earlier this month, and it is a stainless steel reusable straw. You can detach it and then it expands on both ends, and then it has these little silicone ends that are soft. This thing has saved me. I have a pink and a blue one. I think they come as a two pack, and I got them on Amazon. Super, super affordable, and I always keep one in my purse and one in my car, and these have really helped me stick to my no plastic straws rule. And the last product, and probably the product I'm most excited to share that I found on Amazon this month, was reusable makeup removing pads. These are so awesome, and they come with this little bag that has like little mini holes in it to help it ventilate when they're wet. So I just washed these actually, so I have to put them back in my bathroom. There are 16 of these little rounds, and I literally just keep them in my bathroom drawer, and every evening I use one to take my makeup off. What I do, I'll have to do like a nighttime skincare routine video, but I basically use a cleansing balm to loosen up my makeup and do my first initial cleanse. And then I wet this with micellar water, and then I go back through and I take off the rest of my makeup that that cleansing balm didn't get. And I love that you can just wash them when you're done with them. So literally every single night I use two. I use one to help take off the rest of my makeup and the other one for a toner. And these really do help to eliminate some of the waste that cotton balls, cotton rounds, and makeup wipes contribute to. So I've really loved these. So highly recommend them, and they're also super affordable. I will leave the link down below. All right, let's move away from products. Let's get into the kitchen. Let's talk about some new favorites that I discovered this past month in the kitchen. So I am not someone who loves to cook, but I'm really challenging myself this year to get away from spending so much money eating out. So I bought myself two cookbooks. I'll link them down below. They're great, but didn't make the favorites list for the month. And one thing that I recently discovered is that halloumi cheese exists in America. I know that this is so random to a lot of you, and that's okay. But if you know how good halloumi cheese is, if you've had it before, I mean, oh my gosh, y'all. It's one of the things that exists that proves to me that God loves me. It is delicious. And if you haven't ever had it, I cannot encourage you enough to run to your nearest Publix and get your hands on some. It has a green label, and it's halloumi. H-A-L-L-O-U-M-I. It is a Cypriot cheese. A Cypriot or Cyprian? If you are Greek, please let me know which one is correct down below in the comments. And it's delicious. And they have it everywhere in the UK, and that's where I first had it. So it's one of those cheeses that you can't eat by itself, but it's very salty. So I saute mine, and you just kind of want to cut it into slices and make sure it's cooked very well on both sides. And then I cut it up into smaller pieces and I put it on salad. And the it's really good with lemon squeezed on top of it. So I found an amazing lemon vinaigrette recipe online, and I will link that down below. And I will also obviously give credit to the wonderful woman who put that on her blog, because it is delicious. It is pretty healthy, and it's not too tart as well. Like, I know a lot of people don't really love lemon, but it's super, super fresh. And I feel like as we're getting into spring and summer, I know I'm gonna be making it a ton. So highly recommend halloumi cheese and lemon vinaigrette dressing. Everything is linked down below. Are you ready, fish? All right, my next category is the favorite quote that the month left me with. And I know that that's a very weird and kind of random category, but I am someone who weighs words very heavily. I don't know if it's the writer in me. I love to write. I feel like I can really express myself the best in writing. And I'm also a deeply emotional person, so I feel like quotes really do help me figure out my feelings, and they oftentimes make me just feel a little bit better about what I'm feeling or about what I'm wrestling with on the inside. So let me share my favorite quote from the month of January. I have it in my notes here. Don't you dare shrink yourself for someone else's comfort. Do not become small for people who refuse to grow. I mean, is that not a mic drop or what? So, admittedly, I am someone that has a really hard time really speaking my truth and being bold, because I'm always trying to not ruffle any feathers. It's the Enneagram 9, the peacemaker in me, and I get really annoyed with myself. So I feel like this is the year that I really need to buckle up and be okay with not appeasing everyone, because I do have some opinions that might not sit well with everybody. And the reason why I feel like it's time to be honest about those is because it's going to impact the way I do my job. But what is that other quote that I love? Oh, well-behaved women never make history. And I feel like people who are quiet really don't, you know, make any huge contribution to, you know, groundbreaking changes, because they don't take a stand. So I don't know. I'm really trying to step out in faith and really just be okay with being bold in a nice way. Like, I would never want to be, you know, bold or challenge a norm in a way that's very disrespectful. That's never, ever my intention. So yeah, that quote really just spoke to me this month and really encouraged me and reminded me that there's nothing wrong with honoring your growth. All right, my next category is my favorites in entertainment from the month of January. I don't know if I'm only supposed to be talking about products in this video and a monthly favorites video, but I'm gonna do things a little bit differently around here. I feel like there's more to life than things that you can buy, and I feel like there was so many cool things that happened in the entertainment world in January, and I'm here to talk about them. So the first thing that I really enjoyed was the Netflix series Cheer. Oh my gosh. If you have watched it, how fun was that? It was so entertaining, and I was like cheering them on like crazy every single episode. And honestly, I'm gonna just admit something right now. I have slid into Monica's DMs because I need her to be my business coach. Homegirl is a badass, and she is the, like, I would be afraid of her so much so that I would be motivated every single day to do a good job. And I don't know, maybe it's just because I'm self-employed, but there are some days where I'm like, I wish I had someone to just kind of like yell at me right now and tell me to get it together. So I loved Monica and I just loved Jerry. I mean, how could you not? If you have not seen the post on Instagram of him like cheering everybody on at work in the morning, hilarious. I will leave it linked down below because it really just made my day. It was so great. I can't stop smiling just thinking about that whole series. It was so fun. Okay, so the second thing that stood out to me in the entertainment realm in the month of January was Camila Cabello's performance of her song First Man at the Grammys. Oh my gosh, homegirl is, one, such a good singer. I feel like I had no idea that she's had so many hit songs. Like, I've heard all of her hit songs, but I didn't know that she sang them. But that song just wrecked me, wrecked. I had never heard it before, and I could even just cry right now thinking about it. It was so sweet and so endearing, and I feel like it was just something really real and raw, and I think that so many of us love moments like that, especially a Pisces like myself. I'm just like, oh my gosh, that was so emotional. I freaking loved it. Okay, so the third one might be a little weird and maybe a little gross. In the same vein of trying to figure out ways and little changes that I can make in my everyday life to be a little bit more sustainable and contribute to the waste problem that the world is experiencing, I thought, are there alternatives to the standard tampons that most of us buy? Yes, okay, we're gonna talk about it. I know that sounds so random, like why would I think about that? But I mean, the applicators are plastic, and if you think about it, like there's probably some sort of chemical or toxin in the actual tampon itself, and I didn't know for sure. So I went in search of some answers. I mean, there are certain aspects of health that just kind of gross people out, and I know periods are one of those things. But come on, we're all girls around here, right? So let's talk about it. Okay, so I went in search of some answers, and I found an article by Euronews.com, and something really stood out to me. It said, billions of tampons and pads go to landfills every year all over the world, and the non-organic items take up to 500 years to decompose. That's just crazy. So there are some options in this article that I found to be very interesting and helpful in kind of helping me figure out if I want to take one of those routes or not. So I will leave that article down below if you are also a bit curious. I bet that last one left you guys thinking like, wow, she finds some really interesting things to be entertaining. Okay, so let's move on to the next category, which is my most memorable moment from the month of January. So I actually could not choose between two. So the first one is just how warmly you guys have received my hair accessories line with Scentsy that is exclusively sold at Walgreens locations throughout the country. I just can't get over. It still just blows my mind that that's even something that I can like verbalize. Like, it is so cool. I'm so thankful that so many of you have gone out of your way not only to purchase items from the line, but to share the purchases that you've made from the line with your friends and your family. It has, I mean, I could get emotional just even talking about it because it means so much to me. I don't know if all of you follow my Ask Alice and Haley newsletter, but someone had asked where the inspiration came from for this line, and it really came from my mom. If you have followed me for a long time, you know that my mom is no longer around, and I feel like I'm so girly, and a lot of it is because of Jules. She and I spent weekend after weekend after weekend at the mall shopping. I mean, she loved a good deal just as much as I do. And, you know, there were other girly aspects to my childhood that I really just hold near and dear to my heart. It's why I love going to get my hair done, because my mom and I used to do that together quite a bit growing up. And another aspect of our hair that I really remember fondly is when she would do my hair every morning. And because they were such a big thing, like I put a hair accessory in my hair every single morning. or Jules did. She always did my hair. So being able to create a collection that could potentially foster that sort of connection with mothers and daughters today just means a lot. So every single purchase that you've made like has just really just touched my heart in the deepest way possible. And sorry if you hear sound effects in the background, fish and chips are playing. So I really hope you guys know just how much I appreciate you shopping this collection, even if you're not a mother to a daughter and you just bought the products for yourself. Like that is, I made this line for literally every type of woman and girl. Like I wanted everyone to find something that that they felt was their style. The collection is still online, although there are quite a few pieces that are sold out, but if you want to take a look at what is still available online, I will link the Walgreens website link down below. And I will say that once this collection is gone, it's gone. So I would definitely run to your nearest Walgreens location to see if you can snag the pieces that you have been wanting. And again, thank you so much for the support. One last thing, if you are curious as to which Walgreens location near you has the collection, if you go to the Walgreens link below, simply go to one of the product pages and you can use the Find a Store Near Me feature. My second most memorable moment of January was being asked to be a guest on my friend Crystal's podcast called Slow Your Scroll. She launched this podcast back in November of 2019, so it is still a baby podcast, but she's doing a great job with it. It is so fun. She really kind of takes a peek behind the scenes of the influencer world and divulges all the things to the audience. As for my episode, I'm not really sure how she is going to kind of label our episode, so to speak. We talked about a ton of different things, like how I'm gonna shift and do this whole job and be an influencer in a completely different country than I started. So be sure to stay tuned for that. I believe it goes live next Wednesday. And once it is live, I'll be sure to link it down below in the description box. All right, next up we have my favorite clothing purchases from January. All right, the first product I wanna share with you guys is this leopard pleated midi skirt. I just love the sheen on it. I think it's so stunning and beautiful. I love the silky material, and I just think it's such a classic piece to have in your wardrobe. You'll be able to style it in so many different ways. So I went with a more of like a workwear look. I paired it with a cashmere turtleneck, which doesn't have to be cashmere. You can wear whatever kind of turtleneck you want. And then I went with tights and booties, but I think you could easily do some like warmer socks underneath and a pair of like over the knee boots that would look so chic and stunning, especially if you went with like a black turtleneck. But I think you could also edge it up. You could do like a graphic tee with it with Golden Goose sneakers or some really just cool sneakers in general. I think this is such a great piece and you could wear it in tons of different ways. And I believe it is still on sale, so I'll link it down below. All right, my second favorite clothing purchase this past month are these J. Crew Cameron slim fit pants. They come in a high-waisted version and a regular rise version, so definitely check out those. I'll link both of them below. I recently purchased them in this beautiful camel color and styled it with a really pretty white blouse. Again, I'm really trying to share a lot more workwear ideas with you guys per y'all's request. And then I also want to highlight that this retailer brought back the pale pink version that I shared with you guys last January in January 2019, and you guys loved those as well. And the material and the fit of these is just unlike anything else. So I was so excited to see that they had the camel color in my size this year, so I had to snag those. All right, my third favorite clothing purchase from the month of January is this great basic white tee. It's currently in the wash, so I cannot show it to you here, but it is definitely a great purchase. I feel like I'm gonna get a ton of wear out of this. I have a long sleeve tunic tee, very similar to this, but it's just a little bit slimmer in the fit, and I have worn it a ton to the point where it's got some discoloring in the armpit area. Hence this purchase. A lot of you have been asking me for a similar option to that tee, being that I wear a ton underneath sweaters that aren't quite long enough to wear over leggings and under sweatshirts and things like that when I'm wearing leggings and traveling. So this is a really great alternative, and I will link it to the retailer that has the best price as of right now. Last weekend it was on sale. If it's still on sale, I will link it to that sale retailer now. And my last favorite clothing purchase is this gorgeous blouse with a bit of ruching at the neckline, and it is just so gorgeous. So I talk with you guys a lot, or at least I have a lot in the past few months, just really looking at your wardrobe and figuring out like, where are the gaps in my wardrobe? That should be directing your purchases. One of my gaps in my wardrobe is really nice blouses to wear to meetings or a nice event. So I've been on the hunt, and this is one that definitely fit the bill, and I just love that you can also wear it with jeans in addition to a pencil skirt or something of that nature. So I will leave that link down below, as well as that blog post that I wore it in, because it really does give you, you know, a few different things to keep in mind when you are making purchases. All right, my next category is my favorite blog post I shared in January. So I really didn't share a lot of blog posts this past month, to be very honest with you, and that was probably one of the most life-giving changes that I made throughout the month of January. I really allowed myself to slow down and really reflect and think about how I wanted to potentially shift and pivot and change how I do what I do. And I feel like my favorite blog posts from the month of January are the blog posts that really shared my takeaways from that time that I spent reflecting. I feel like sometimes we sit and reflect and we think that it's gonna just take 10 minutes and that's all the time that we need to take. But sometimes I think it's when you really do mull over things for a while that you really have the strongest and most profound takeaways. So the blog posts that I would love for you to take a look at and that were my favorite in January are my focus word of 2019 and my 2020 resolutions post. Be sure to check those out in the description box below. All right, to end, I just wanna say thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have not already, be sure to hit the subscribe button below and turn on the notifications by hitting the notification bell below. That will give you a little heads up as to when new videos hit my channel. And just a little piece of housekeeping, I have finally set up my upload schedule, and I'm pretty sure we're gonna be good to go from here on out. New videos will hit my channel on Thursdays and Sundays, and you do not want to miss this Sunday's video. It is all about my closet clean out, and I give you guys a few little tips as to how to declutter your closet. So come back and see me on Sunday. See you guys later. Bye.